So what have I discovered after 19 years of teaching organic chemistry or teaching slash tutoring organic chemistry? I've realized that students don't do well in organic chemistry because organic chemistry is difficult. They don't do well in it because they lack confidence. You see, students go into organic chemistry and they've heard the story of it's a weed out course. It's one of the hardest courses you're going to take. Everybody fails it. And so why should you think that you won't? So that's what they're going into this class, is with a fear, a lack of confidence. And that's when they look at their textbook, that's what they're seeing, is all of that negativity. You know, in my sessions, what I discover is the students all come, and some of them, most of them are not in like a panic state. There's just kind of some issues here and there. But when I ask them, all of them have heard these horror stories and say that maybe they're not doing as well as they want, or they just really want to pass, or whatever that might be. But what I discover after every session is that students always do better. And a lot of them move towards the top of the class very quickly. And I realized, and I started to think, well, I mean, I'm not any different than any other tutor. I mean, I'm just like anybody else that's taken, you know, gotten the degrees or been teaching. So what is it? And I realized that it's not necessarily the organic chemistry that I'm teaching, but it's how I'm teaching, I think. I think it's the style. I think it's the presentation. I think it's the manner, and I think it's the context. And it's not about the material. Because I started to really kind of break down how I taught, because for me, it's always just been spontaneous. I never really prepare for it, and I just do it. And people would ask me, you know, well, what do you do? And I never really knew. So I would just sit down, and I realized that a lot of the stuff that I do is essentially positive reinforcement. And it's not a lot of it is not talking about organic chemistry. I mean, like, we'll sit and I'll kind of explain some general concepts, and then the students will be like, oh, well, that makes sense, you know, and then they might say, well, can you give me some examples? And I'll write some examples. And then while I'm writing the examples, they're already predicting the products. So it shows the fact that that students do know how to do it. But it's just a matter of removing those obstacles, that negativity that's in front of it. Because to be honest, the material is not that difficult. I found numerous ways of taking organic chemistry. For example, most of you probably know me. I've got the SN1, SN2, E1, E2 cheat sheet that I put up. I've got that for free on my website and put it on Instagram. And that when students see that, they can't believe how simple it is. I mean, like, for those reactions, for those of you that are familiar, I mean, there's like solvents, there's carbon substitution, there's nucleophilicity, there's basicity, there's how well something, you know, is electron withdrawing. I mean, factor after factor after factor, you know, solvents. And this goes on for page after page after page. You know, I've taken all of that and simplified it to its core elements and put it on one sheet. And when I teach that to students, it takes maybe a couple of minutes. And it essentially goes over all the core principles and all the key elements that you need. Now, all of that stuff obviously is important because scientists have spent a tremendous amount of time studying those reactions. So it's not to take away from that at all. All of those things contribute. But what I've discovered is that when you sit down, you actually have to work a question. You have to answer a question. A lot of that information is not necessary to answer the question. It helps you get a greater understanding, but the question itself, it does not necessitate any of that information. And what I found with organic chemistry is you can take the whole of organic chemistry and break it down into these key principles that you can literally apply over everything else, kind of like a template. And once you apply that template, everything is simple, everything is easy, and there's no problem. So for me, what it comes down to is it's not the material. It's essentially letting the students first know that they can do it, that they have all the capabilities of do it, because they're rocking out a lot of their other classes. A lot of the students that come to me have A's and everything else. They're just getting tripped up in organic chemistry, just like I'm getting tripped up as I talk. But it's not the material. It's the fact that you have to remove those false beliefs about the fact that it's difficult.